Australia's housing crisis will likely get worse before it gets better, with the pace of new home construction slowing. Higher interest rates are hurting the market, with the government's own targets now under threat.
From high-rises on horizons to the urban sprawl, tonight Australia simply isn't building enough homes.
The next couple of years are going to remain very tough for those trying to enter the housing industry and for renters especially.
National Cabinet set a target of 1.2 million homes over 5 years beginning in July. New South Wales already say they won't meet their goal, and they're not alone.
We're starting from a low base. We're starting from a long way behind the eight ball. We've got a lot of catching up to do.
We've got no shortage of ambition, no shortage of government effort and policy, but there are challenges in the housing marketplace.
Construction started on just 22,741 new private sector houses in the 3 months until September. According to the Bureau of Statistics, down 9.7% seasonally adjusted on the 3 months prior, down almost 22% on 2022.
We'll work hard to achieve that target, but I think like New South Wales, every state will say it's going to be tough.
The numbers that have been set are a challenge and we'll continue to do all we can.
This week, the Queensland government purchased a hotel to provide emergency accommodation. Now the Sunshine State may light the way, meeting construction goals.
My advice is that we will.
Higher interest rates make financing harder, higher demand causing labour and material shortages. Higher migration post-COVID also a factor.
People don't want to buy. It's very difficult to build, and there's record migration.
Cost of living remains the number one issue for Australians, and for so many, the cost of housing is the number one contributor to the cost of living. Charles Croucher, Nine News.